Hello and welcome back to Pulling the Perfect Key in DaVinci Resolve with me, Ben Brownlee from Boris FX. And this is part two of Pulling the Key. So if you're in any doubt about pulling the primary key, go back and watch part one now. If you've already done that and you're just interested in spill suppression, then let's get on with that. Okay, so I'm going to close up my nodes to give us a little bit more space. And I'm going to zoom in on the hair and move my HUD over here a little bit because I'm going to talk a bit about spill suppression. Now, spill is what happens when we're filming against a brightly coloured background and that light reflects back onto the subject or is visible in semi-transparent areas like sheer clothing or fine hair, and it can create this sort of halo around our subject. Now, as we know, we shot this against green screen, and we're looking at this against a green forest. Now, some people consider that cheating, especially when I'm talking about spill suppression, because looking at green spill against a green background is a little bit tricky. The background can help to hide some of our sins. So while you were taking a break in between part one and here, I actually came in and added another clip in between our background and our subject, just so that we can have a look at the spill in a bit more detail. So if we have a look at this now, you can still see that we're getting quite a bit of green spill coming in off our background and coming in through the fine hair. We're also getting it reflected in the sword down at the bottom here and probably over in this area around the clothing as well. So what can we do to help fix it? Well, there's one way to do it using the tools we have in the UI. And the first one is a spill sponge. So if I click on my spill sponge and just go across some of the areas that are causing us issues, we can try and use this to suck up some of the spill. But as you can see in this case, it's being a little bit aggressive. And if things are being a bit aggressive, we have our spill plus and spill minus down at the bottom here to try and help fix that. So spill plus brings our spill back. Spill minus takes our spill away. It's not spill suppression minus, it's spill minus. So it's trying to help to get rid of some of that spill. And as you can see, I still have some of that nasty, pesky spill staying in. So I'm going to show you another way of dealing with this. And I'll just undo a few times to take us back to where we started. So let's come over to the settings in the Open Effects panel. And I'm going to come down to spill. And I have different ways of dealing with spill. I can do things as a complementary color. So what happens here is Primatte Studio looks at the color we've keyed out and tries to put in the complementary color back into the spill there. We can base this on a solid color. So finding a solid color that we like. And you can see that updating in real time. Go, let's just cancel that out. And there's also an option for softened BG, softened background. Now, unfortunately, as the big thing says here, if I hide my UI, we can see this a bit better. Due to host limitations, spill correction from softened background is not supported in Resolve. So we can't pipe in another source directly into our plugin. But that's not a big issue. I'm going to take us back to complementary and zoom us back in again. Because I'm going to take our spill replace amount down to zero. So this is no spill suppression and this is with spill suppression. So no spill suppression there. And the reason I'm not worried about it is because I have this secondary spill remover. So if I turn that on, take a look at what happens to my image. That sucks out that nasty green, even from areas where I was having difficulty getting it with the other tools. And the secondary spill remover has different removal methods, whether it's a channel limiter or using the classic continuum remover. Generally speaking, I'd leave that at default. Screen type, again, generally speaking, I'd leave that at default unless you're not getting the result you desire. And at that point, you can then come in and choose which channel you're going to start to affect. And stick with green, no surprises there. I can also come in to my channel bias here and mix that back until I find a result that fits my subject but actually I quite like the bias being at 50 here. Now, the really cool thing about the Primatte Studio spill suppressor is that even though we're using the secondary spill remover, I can still mix in a little bit of the other spill suppressor as well. So this could be handy when we just need to add in a little bit more color into our fine details. And generally speaking, I usually keep this between about 10 and 25, but you know, there's nothing stopping you from taking it all the way up to 100 if you're getting a better result there. In this case, I'm not, so I'm going to leave it around about sort of 14. It's looking pretty good. So without the secondary spill remover and with the secondary spill remover, it's a huge, huge difference. And knowing that we can do so much with spill remover is one of the big reasons why I wasn't so aggressive with my key when we were pulling the primary mat. Because I knew that when we played this back, we could actually afford to keep in a lot of the hair details that looked sort of green and ropey, because I knew I was going to be able to fix those in the next step. So let's see how that looks now against our actual background. So I'm going to turn off V2. And let's see the difference the spill remover makes when we are looking at that. Before and after. Before and after. I still think that's making a big difference. And getting it with this sort of level of detail already is going to help us in the next few stages when we start to composite this in properly. There we go. And that's starting to look quite nice. So in the next few steps, when we start to look at the compositing properly, this is going to give us a lot more flexibility than we would otherwise have. Let's just zoom out, put us into primary mat, and let's play that back now just to see where we are in terms of the key and what we have left to do. So as we left it in exercise one, our primary key is looking pretty good. We can see that we still have a lot of stuff on the right hand side and the left hand side. We have the sword we need to sort out. And if we go forward over here, we have our shield to sort out. Look at the final composite. You'll also pick up a few of the problems with the shield. If I turn our Primatte Studio on and off, you can see because we haven't got a clean mat on our shield, this is also going to get affected by the spill suppressor. So we don't want that. And this means that in the next exercise, we're in a good position to take a look and another couple of things we can do with Primatte Studio, the outside mask and the inside mask, to create hold-in and hold-out mats. So join me, Ben Brownlee from Boris FX, in part 3 of pulling the perfect key in DaVinci Resolve. And I'll see you in the next video. If you're enjoying it so far, please remember to hit the like button before you watch the next video. For the latest news and tutorials, remember to go to borisfx.com. If you want to follow along with this, use the download link in the description.